Hey, I'm PJ Fender, guitarist, coffee drinker, philosopher, extraordinary.
Man, Mike, bass player.
Patrick, drums.
Rick Roger, all vocals. These guys all do backup vocals on the tape.
And we are
RETALLIATION! Alright, it's something a little different than what you would normally receive on with the demo tape. We figured since we can't speak with any of you in person, we might as well send a little
bit of something extra here. Maybe all the way back.
We got him to state prison.
So, this is our demo, man. What do you guys think, man?
It's been longer than anything.
It's a fucking ordeal for me, man. I'm telling you that.
I had some highs and lows, man. It's good shit, man.
What you think, Justin? What do you like, man?
The last time I played, it didn't really go that well.
Yeah. I tell you, man, I wish we could have taken this far, you know what I mean? But the way we all came together and got this shit going, it's like, you know, we kind of started out our way, you know what I mean? And as the tune started to progress, I mean, the band was progressing. The enemy, that last tune, I mean, like I said, we just barely learned that and threw it down, because, you know, I'm on my way out of here, we were getting short, but, you know, that tune there shows the direction that this band was going. It's,
well, from when we started, like you say, we started off not exactly knowing where it was developing into. You know, you can see that through the progression of the songwriting. You know, being the enemy, the most recent tune, before that was the Nazi. And honestly, I can't remember which one we were up before that.
Gives a fuck. I know we started with Possession, man. Hey, I thought when I first heard that, when we first was doing it, man, I hated that fucking tune.
Hey, let me just put on one of our live tapes in the background here. Okay, here we go. This is a session we did, I'd say, sometime in July. You can only hear it in the background. Now, let me see how it's picking up. Maybe I can bring the volume up a little bit.
So anyways, as you were saying about Possession?
I still cringe when I hear that tune, man. You know, I'm like, wow, 19, I wrote that fucking tune, you know?
That's my least favorite.
I tell you, when I hear it now, after we're through the harmonizing and shit, I like it. You know what I mean? I like it better now. It ended up being all right. But, I don't grind, man.
Hey, that's a marsh tune all the way.
I tell you, first thing when you see this tape back, man, I start hearing that shit, man, I just want to kill somebody. You know what I mean?
You know, in the concept of writing all around our prison, both of the tunes being arranged, I think, to people out that have this day that are listening to this now, you know, you get more of an idea of really what it's like, you know, the emotion, all our experiences we put into this music, and I know I have into the lyrics. You know, we get really, I get, you know, I feel it inside when I start going, you know, up there singing.
First of all, I think everybody should understand about, you know, only the 4 hours a week of practice to be able to put in this year.
We have more practice.
Yeah.
You know, how
tall we were here with each other. You know, 100% better. You can't do it until now. 100%.
I know for me, man, this came, you know, it's like, look, you know, we're like fucking dead, man. You know what I mean? This is like, to me, this came, the thing about this came, it's like a lifeline, you know?
know, we're in here, we're doing our thing, you know, we're in here, you know, I'm 100% with my music, but, you know, if you're struggling, people are going to hear this, you know, we don't have an audience in there, you know, we got a few guys come down and, you know, we really, you know, so, we don't really know what an audience is going to think of me, you know, but just knowing that's going out there, you know, it's like,
July 12, 1995, when we did the outdoor concert up on the roof of this music bunk here, we didn't get quite an audience. You know, 250 people is not more convicts, and then you had all the staff that was there. They didn't know what the hell was thinking. I mean,
we did get some looks, man, you know?
You know, afterwards we had things that we didn't even expect come up to us and say, hey, excellent, you know? You know, people out there 20 years old, 30 years old, 40 years old out there, swinging their fucking heads to our music.
But get out of these guys in my community. One day, fucking prison audience, they're the worst, man. They don't want something for nothing.
Yeah.
Even if you were good, man, they don't want to admit to you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. But people on the streets, you know, Try, think about it. Imagine how hard it is for us to play in front of a bunch of comics who give a fuck less. They ain't paying for the show. You know, but we held that audience. If you can play in front of a prison audience, you can play in front of 10,000, 100,000 people.
Ain't gonna be anybody.
That's
what
we get back.
Oh, yeah.
But you know, the thing that sucks about me, you know, like I said, the day you listen to that tape, man, they might fucking blood and fall. You know what I'm saying? You know, it's like, I'm sitting there listening, it's like, you know what I mean? It's like, you know, you can't get that feedback from people. Like, you know, I listen to a lot of people, man, shit, you know what I mean? We don't get that feedback, man. That would be me.
Yeah.
Hey, that's our engineer, man.
About
this whole thing. Got to introduce. Me and Larry definitely had some moments with the fucking making the state. Got to introduce Larry to Charlie. That's it.
Larry, why don't you come out here for a minute so we can pick you up a little better out here. Okay, Larry doesn't want to come.
He never wants to be out here.
We did have some moments in the parking studio. I thought we
had
a couple times there. I mean, I had a fucking stress pitch, man. A couple days there, I was fucking exploding inside. Fuck this. You know what I mean? I hate this weird shit. I like playing high. You know what I mean? I like the energy of music. I had a hard time getting into this fucking studio shit.
Well, it can get stressful. Like we say, 4 hours a week to actually come down and record. Now, it's taken us how long longer than we expected to ever finish this, you know?
Oh yeah, you'd be able to stress at being waking up by bells, counted by bells.
Playing chair, all that shit, wouldn't it?
Yeah,
anybody tell me what a group bass system sound like?
Really? Yeah. I tell you, I had that 3 weeks then, you know, I don't know what happened. I couldn't even play. Yeah. I had that 3 weeks in a row, man. About one fucking keep on the floor. I was suicidal at that point. I was ready to pick up. Yeah, you didn't fucking talk, man. You know, I'm happy.
I wish we had more time. I wish we could go another one.
I might just have to get busted to it.
You know, the guitarist, Paul Fredericks, he's hitting streets too. You know, anybody, maybe traveler, maybe interested, you know, possibly checking out the situation. I don't know how Paul is about moving across the country or around the fucking world.
Yeah,
but, you know,
I'm going anywhere for the chair, man. I'm here.
Contact, you know, me through the address inside the tape, Dodo.
Rick Rosen.
If you don't have the address, then we have been featured in numerous scenes, and we'll be featured in many more. As many as we can get into, as a matter of fact. Any scenes you are interested, contact me at the address,
me out soon. I'm looking for the chance, you know.
Anybody wants to donate equipment, can do that too.
Yeah! Hey, by the way, as we sit here right now, it's fucking Halloween, man.
I'm sober.
1995, man. Yeah?
What a day of things to come.
Don't think it.
It's Friday the 13th, but.
Anyway.
There it is. Hey, Halloween, what's up?
Yeah.
This is a cup of tea is filled with some alcoholic beverages. Dr. Michael.
Any highlights about any song's quality and time? Dig them all.
I tell you, well, you know, like I said, possession, well, that's one of them that makes me drink. But yeah, the rest of them I had. For the first time, man, I'm happy with hearing shit that I did. A lot of times, anytime I really record anything, I hear myself in the back of my place. I'm kind of like, what the fuck was I doing? You know? But on this one here, yeah, oh, man, you know, yeah. When I came out of my slump there, it was like, dang, man, it just all came together. Actually, a couple of them were before the slump. You know, with the drop lead, right to them. Now my second coming, those two, and after that, I don't know what happened. We said nothing, we couldn't pull shit. But when we came back, quiet and heavy, I proud of working, you know, and
well, if we're gonna need our time schedule on this tape, we're gonna have to wrap up this little rap session here. And I'd like to thank everybody who bought the tape. Thank everybody who promoted us. I'd like to thank everybody in the band Retaliation. Mike.
DJ
Frederick. Jared. Yep. Ben.
Whatever you want, you dog. I can't handle my names, man.
Larry, thank you for all you've done. And quite a few people have helped out and with us and give it a little bit of their time so we can get this done. So thanks to them. Thanks to my mom and dad because
without them,
none of this would be possible because of Dad handling all of the sales end of it.
Thanks, Mom, Dad.
Thanks, Mom.
Thanks, Mom. Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, if you like what you hear, man, drop
us a line. Push us. Get us out there.
I want to say, how would you get some feedback?
Get us out of the
way. Fly us a kite, tell us what you think of band and music.
Tell your friends. Everybody's got to have this thing. We are the first prison death metal band.
That's it. You ain't going to hear it nowhere else, man.
Keep your eyes on us. Keep in touch with us.
Retaliation.
Retaliation. 1995.